Well, Jeremy, how did you rate that as a performance? Better even, a step back from last week?
Oh, different game to last week, you know. Last week we played in the hard, fast ground in Queenstown. First game of the season, so everyone was really excited about playing. We're playing in Queenstown, lovely day. This game, we had to get on the plane this morning at 8 o'clock and, you know, fly up, sit in a rugby club for 4 hours, wait around for the game, and then get on the bus and drive here and then play. Now we've got to get on a plane and go home again. So not the ideal preparation for us. And with that in mind, I guess that pays part of the reason why we were flat and a little bit slow in the first half, first 40 minutes. And then the second half got cracking. And the guys sort of got onto that game, scored 15 points. But unlucky, I thought, at the end, with another try-scoring opportunity. And, you know, we leaked a couple of tries in the first half. So, look, if we can sort of sort that out and start a little bit better, then the team will get better.
And a couple of their tries were when you were attacking, a turnover ball.
That's right, yeah. So we're hard on attack in there, 22. Slippery weather, the ball slips out. And then all of a sudden, the 0 day runs 80 metres, and we did that twice. So that's 14 points. 14 and 28 minus 14 is 14, 15, 14. I don't know.
I thought a bit of scrum today, though, but more solid platform.
Yeah. So we've got a young, relatively young front row, really. Yeah. Chris King sort of evens the average out a little bit, but, you know, Matthias is 20. Kane Hames, new to the game. You know, I guess that was a tough scrum in that second half. And I think the guys can hold their heads up pretty high. We played a all-back type five, and they it's a pre-season match, so I'm not taking too much out of it. But if anything, you know, front row is pretty proud about that part of the job, and so we've taken a little bit of confidence out of that.
And they're still playing to the end. Obviously, their fitness levels are quite good for this time of the year.
Yeah, so yeah, we're playing with squads. Both teams are playing with squads, 28, 29 players. So you take six away, then there'll be a bit of fatigue. And that's really what it's about. When guys start hurting physically and fitness-wise and starts kicking in, and mentally you've got to be on the money. So we'll be testing that next week.
And just finally, a word for Buxton. Terribly bad luck for the young man.
Yeah, I'm really sad about Buxton. And Buxton is, so I've coached Buxton since he was a kid and brought him in the Wellington scene and then brought him down south and things have gone now. I just thought this year was his year. He really matured as a boy. He's now a young man. He's very fit and very strong. Third season involved with the Highlanders. I just felt that it was his year really to stake a claim for, you know, for higher honours. And I really rate the young boy. I'm really shame that he's got the sickness. I just hope he can come back.
Well, Ryan, the winning of that game was that first 20 minutes, wasn't it? You put on a very good starting performance.
Yeah, we brought the physicality early, I think, and probably surprised them a wee bit. We wanted to show our intent early by starting physical. I think they made a couple of crucial turnovers that we really pounced on, which we're really happy about. Our back three were working hard on the back of those to score a couple of long-range tries. And, you know, we got our gun going pretty early, played good field position. So, yeah, some positives out of that first 20, 40 minutes, yeah.
Yeah, good to see the confidence in the counter-attacking play.
Yeah, especially given the conditions. I guess that's a kind of vision for us this year. You know, we really want to play and have a go from anywhere if it's on to do so. So, you know, we back guys like Izzy and our wingers to make the right calls if it's on, and we've just got to trust those and give the pill.
Did you change your game plan as the match went on, as the weather got worse?
Well, I think it got worse and then didn't really change the game plan. I think it was more the skill set started to suffer a wee bit. Both teams were guilty of dropped balls and that really kind of stunted the momentum. So, I guess it was just the conditions. Game tightened up a wee bit. Both teams trying to play to them. But it is what it is. You've got to do what you do to adapt in conditions like that. And I think the Highlanders probably did it a wee bit better than us towards the end of the game there.
You've played in a few seasons now for the Crusaders. What about preparation this time last year, about the same place?
Oh, we're well ahead of where we have been in previous seasons. We've had a lot more focus on the rugby side of things as opposed to just focusing on fitness. So it's really good that we're having discussions now that we were having midway through the season last year. So in that perspective, it's a real positive. It's exciting because it means we can start, I guess, evolving our game and shaping our attack a wee bit differently. So, yeah, I think the benefits of spending a little bit of time with ball in hand pre-season is showing dividends now.
And the young guys in the squad all moulding together nicely and getting the feel for the top level football?
Yeah, it's great. We don't have too many new young guys, but those guys that are a wee bit younger, they're adding, you know, they're bringing the excitement to training. They're really keen to learn and they're showing their stuff. I guess guys like Nuffy and Rob Thompson, probably two out there today that were pretty sharp. Yes, it's good to see. You know, they're excited. They're pushing the guys that probably have had that jersey on in the past. So it's good to have that kind of competition in the squad at the moment. Pressure on places, that's for sure.
But also the fact that you can keep continuity going from season to season, the bulk of the squad staying together for the most part.
Yeah, well, I guess that's a credit to the contracting team, the Crusaders. They do a good job at keeping the core group of players together and those guys that come in buy straight into the values and vision that we have in the team. And I guess that's important. If we're all going for the same thing, then we're going to be a pretty tough horse to stop.
And the excitement building in the camp, the real season's only a couple of weeks away.
Yeah, it is, but we've got to perform pre-season to start the season well, which we might not have done in the past. So a lot more emphasis on performing well pre-season than we possibly might not have in the past. So guys need to perform well to try and get that starting spot, and then I guess that'll build momentum leading into the first game against the Chiefs.
Well, Josh, not the prettiest day conditions-wise, but that might be the way game day.
Yeah, I know. You've got to be ready for that type of weather. And, I guess we weren't out there today. A few balls went to ground and Crusaders picked up on it and scored some tries from it. So, got to get used to it. It's been a bit quite sunny in Dunedin lately. So, came up here, I thought it was going to be sunny. But, we'll learn from our lesson.
They dominated possession in the early quarter, didn't they? It was hard to get the ball off them.
Yeah, we struggled with our line out early on. And they did quite well when they had the ball, making the gain line. So it just felt like we didn't have the ball much at the start and couldn't get a roll on. By the end of the first half, I thought that we were getting down their half and we were about to score and we had some good opportunities, but they just didn't go our way. Second half, the boys came out firing and thought they did it a bit better.
I thought the guys 2 weeks in a row now showing some ticker because behind on the scoreboard on a rotten day, but kept trying.
Yeah, I guess that's the way you got to be. Keep on working on it, and we're always striving for that win, so it's always going to happen. And it's just disappointing we didn't come away with it today.
I know you didn't play last week, but I thought the scrum improved today, a bit more solid.
Yeah, I felt just watching from last week, we worked on heaps just with the new rules. Now it's a lot harder for the front row and the tight fives, so we did a bit more work on it this week, and it paid off. I thought we were quite good.
Defence wasn't quite as tight in the early stages, but improved as the game went on.
Yeah, I thought so. There was a few gaps around the middle that they exposed us in, but by the end of it, we're going right. We'll just have to work on that next week.
A couple of those tries they scored too were a counter-attack from depth.
Yeah, exactly. When the ball gets loose and unstructured, we have to account for that as well. So they're making easy breaks off our mistakes and scoring off them and running back. Those runaways, hurts. They hurt.
Enjoy captaining the team?
Yeah, it was a good experience. Enjoyed running out there with the boys, It was a good feeling within the team, and it was an honour to lead the Highlanders.
And a team trip to round off the pre-season?
Yeah, off to Sydney next week. So I'll say we're a bit more hotter there, so the old lungs might hurt a bit, but looking forward to getting over there and hopefully grab a win.